Many people here used to ring in the new year with all kinds of fireworks, but not anymore since the fireworks ban took effect on Oahu in 2010.
But that could change. Today, a city council committee moved forward a bill to ease that ban. Now, if it goes through, folks may once again be able to play with sparklers and fountains. People would still have to buy a permit to use them on certain holidays.
Honolulu is the only county in the state that bans fireworks, and those who favor the ban, such as the fire and police departments, say it's working. Manolo Morales follows up with this report.
The Honolulu Fire Department says the bottom line is there were fewer injuries since the ban, and the ban is also saving the city money because they don't have to staff as many people during New Year's Eve.
With the ban in place, the fire department says there have been 17 injuries and more than 3 fires per year on New Year's Eve. Go back to the previous 3 years. Before the ban, there were 67 injuries and 45 fires per year.
Those averaged $101,000 damage a year. In the past 3 years, averaged $500 damage a year. In addition, we used to staff additional personnel.
But those who favor easing the ban say it's not clear if at least some of those injuries are caused by other illegal fireworks, such as aerials.
There seems to be more illegal fireworks being used and somewhat dangerous. If there are people that are using illegal fireworks, then we should go after them.
National statistics provided by a lobbyist was an eye-opener for council members, showing firecrackers cause 11% of fireworks-related injuries, fountains only 3%, but sparklers cause 31% of the injuries.
The policy decision is up to the council, but it sounds like the council might be moving in the direction of only allowing fountains as opposed to sparklers.
But the fire and police departments tell us the ban should stay the way it is. The bill moves to the full council on July 8th for the second of 3 public hearings. Manolo Morales, KHON 2 News.